Welcome to In the Vault, a new program from the Museum of Riverside. We're here to talk today about some of the examples from our stellar Indigenous North American basketry collection. And with me is Brenda Vogt, our curator who's in charge of the Indigenous resources.
Hello.
What have we got here?
We have actually five baskets, you're seeing four right now, that have a very interesting story. Because in 1899, Christmas, there was an earthquake at San Jacinto. And that earthquake caused a lot of damage, killing six Indigenous women. And later years, when the museum was given these baskets, on the record it said that the makers of these baskets were killed in the San Jacinto earthquake. San Jacinto is where the Saboba Band of Luiseno Indians are located. And that tribe has peoples of Kuya and Luiseno heritage that live together. So it's interesting because some of the baskets, like this one for example, the record says it has a Kuya influence. And we know that one of the women that were killed, she was Kuya and she married a Luiseno man. And that she stayed at Saboba. So these baskets all are made of juncus, sumac, and grass. Those are the basic plant materials that are used by Southern California Indigenous basket makers. And they have their motifs are also have connections. You have flowers. We have flowers on a basket right over there. You will find insects. That one also has the insects. You could find plant materials, like they grew corn, and so you'll often see, like you see along here, the corn plant, and you'll see reptiles, which could be frogs or they could be lizards. So the people saw what was in their environment and recreated them in the basketry that they made. But this one basket right here, we know in the records it has a mountain Kuya association, and the one woman that was of mountain Kuya heritage, her name is Toriba Lucero, and she married a Luiseno man and lived at Saboba. So this is about the only basket we have here that we could actually maybe be fairly accurate in our identification. This basket over here is also attributed to Mountain Kuya supposedly, but we don't know who the maker is.
But we do know it's one of those six women.
Yes, we know it's one of the six women because of the records. This basket has had a lot of fame in the museum's collection. It comes from the La Jolla Reservation. The maker was killed in that earthquake. But its story goes beyond that. It becomes sort of an American icon because the former curator of anthropology, Christopher Mosier, he made this collection what it is by the documentation and the research he did. And he always thought that a basket should be on a U.S. postal stamp because he was a stamp collector. And so he lobbied the U.S. Postal Service people, and finally they sort of succumbed to his harassment, you might say, and said, well, we'll put a stamp on, a basket on a stamp when we open up the National Museum of the American Indian, and you may choose one of your baskets from the collection. And this one with the water bug and the flower was what was chosen. It was the only basket that was on the pane of eight stamps, and this was the only basket. And they were made by Indigenous people from museums, but this was the stamp basket.
Thank you for joining us with In the Vault. You can find more information about our collection by contacting our staff. Thank you very much for joining us.